Hello everybody, it's Furball here again and welcome back to No Man's Sky. Now please do remember, if you do enjoy watching this video, please remember to like, subscribe, comment and share. So in the end of the last episode, we were looking for some manufacturing plants and we found, and also some monoliths. What's that over there shining? Go and have a look. What is it? It's flora, interact health. Okay, have we discovered that? Yes, okay. I thought we should have a look at the waypoints, shouldn't we? Oh yes, because we're nearly out there. So let's just upload it. Yeah, so if you haven't figured out already, unless somebody can tell me a way, I don't think you can scroll along the waypoints. So if you don't upload them within 6 discoveries, you can't upload them and you lose those credits. So we were looking at learning the lingo. So that we could solve the puzzles at the manufacturing plants to get some more, get some more technology to craft. And we discovered a plaque and what was the other one? That's a monolith. Manufacturing facility. Where is it? I don't know. There was something like operations center or something like that. It was, wasn't it? But we'll get in the ship and we're going to have a look. What's this here? This would be zinc. Hey, bit of zinc. There we go. Right. Oh, that's all Jimbo. Monolith. Well, we said we'd have a look at what the plaque. We're curious as to what a plaque is. It's probably just a plaque, really, isn't it? But it's clearly defined from being a standard monolith. So, okay. So we land a bit far away again still. It's separated from being a monolith. So it'd be interesting to see what the difference is at the end of the day, wouldn't it? It looks a bit more like a block than a plaque, but, you know, I suppose... Akmanabu landmark, Gek plaque. Okay. Memories imbued into the rock long ago by the ancient Gek Hanau. Is that his name or like a descriptive term for him? Hanau. Ancient Gek Hanau into my... What the hell does Hanau mean? I don't know. I'm going to have to look that up. Is it a word? Is it not a word? Maybe it'll be within the language. So... Memories imbued into the rock long ago by the ancient Gek Hanau. Hanau into my brain. Okay. I recall because I'm just confused as to what a Hanau is. Would that be channel? I bet it's channel. It's got to be channel, hasn't it? They've got a channel into my brain. Okay. I recall, but I am compelled to somehow understand. Through time and space, the firstborn endures eternally, ever watchful and yielding over its dominion. Each foe will be crushed, only the Gek will remain. Well, you're not succeeding very much with that at the moment, are you? There you go. We'll find some more lingo. My language. Could I depart? Okay. So Hanau was just... I just kept thinking... what are they called? In Red Dwarf, genetically engineered. No, the things that Lister marries. I can't remember now. Because they have the language is like, that's what Hanau made me think about. there we go. But I assume it's channel. That's my deduction for the day. Is that it's channel. Are there any more? There's usually a lot of, right, okay. So I should figure this. So a hexagon is obviously a sort of landmark, stone monolith thing that I've discovered. And the diamonds are things that I found with my scanner. I should remember that. It's an obvious distinction to make. Still haven't got the please don't blind me mod. Right. Any more? There's a purple diamond over there. Let's go for that one. Let's grab that one. And then we get back in the ship. And we find out what this other thing is, which... Wait! Jumpy jumpy. There we go. Right. Where's it gone now? Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Over here. There it is. Oh. Ah. Sensitive trigger. Learn a word for temperature. Temperature is getting hot. Please turn down. I was just thinking, can we actually land in these trees somehow? We need me to... I'm not going to try too hard. Because I'll probably miss it. We just look down, look down, look down. In the tree, in the tree. Oh, yes! Oh, wow! Cool. Excellent. I am standing on a leaf. I'm hidden. I'm not from this side. But this side, I'm camouflaged. Looking out for my dinner. Is there anybody there? Can't see anything. Are there any mysterious animals? Like this way? No. Nothing. So yeah, you can land on big leaves. There you go. I keep looking at this, and it kind of makes me think of, what's it? Bender out of Futurama. That's what it makes me think of. Oh, just an angry robot face in general. Take off. Take it. Oh, best fuel up. Fuel up. Right. Shelter. Monolith. Well, that monolith's quite close. As is this. What are we going to have a look at? Operation Center. That's the word. Or words. More precisely. So if we head this way, we'll go here. We'll go to the monolith. Landing area not clear. Right, there. Is that the one? Ooh, it's a drop pod. Is it a drop pod? Yes! Yes! Drop pod. Excellent! Free drop pod. Didn't have to search for that one. Free, well, I'll have to buy it. But I didn't have to expend a thingy chip on it to get it. Plutonium? No, it must be thamium. Okay. Oh, did I? I'm not sure if I picked two at once then. Oh, yeah, I could probably do a little bit of plutonium. Because we are taking off a lot. Oh, hello, who are you? You're like the big roo, aren't you? Hello, space dough. Yeah, it looked more like a... In the picture, it looked like a female deer. In real life, it looks like an oversized kangaroo. Or maybe you completely disagree with that as well. But that's what I thought and what I think now. No, that's not a thingy bob scanner, whatchamacallit. How far away are these? Oh, there's loads of crystals there. Let's go and zap them quickly. Hello, boop-a-doo, boop-a-doo. Zap all. Oh, so I don't think I mentioned in the last thing, I have upgraded my multi-tool a bit as well. I added that one, I think. And it does seem like it's got a bit more, when I was mining some of the big things, it had a bit more oomph behind it, really. Made it a bit easier. So it's a good upgrade system to do. Yes, alright, I'm off now. See you later. I've collected them anyway. Ship, where's my ship? Run away. Not that I'm really scared of the sentinels, but... it's just bothering it. Unneeded bother. Oh my god, there's too many icons. Your ship icon should be massive. But... holding my head in my hand. I am standing next to the ship. Going, where is the ship on my hood? It's right next to you. It's probably why it's not on the hood, because it's right next to you. Oh, none of the fuel. Okay. Yeah, it's a good job I didn't have to make a quick getaway, wasn't it? Because there's no fuel in the tank. There we go. Thank you. Right, we're off. Are we heading in the... I don't know, we kind of turned round here. I think we sort of turned round, haven't we? Have we? Monolith. We're going for that one. Have you noticed in the top left-hand corner, I've got like a little mini speaker? That's what I think it is, anyway. It's either that or it's one of those ventilation things that you have in your window in your kitchen, in case I do a bit of cooking in it or something and have to expel the steam or smoke if you set things on fire. Apologies for the flickering. I hope it doesn't affect anybody adversely in any way, shape, or form. If it does, please let us know. Call the number below. Just, yeah, make a comment and I'll pass it on to the mod guy. Or put a comment in the mod guy's mod. Oh, I've discovered this, haven't I? Have I? Yes. Discovered this. So that was another wasted landing. Okay. That is a very tentative. Yeah, that's. She's put the ship in the gymnastics in the Olympics. One-handed handstand. Hello? 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 Take off. Right. Go. Yes. Right. Okay. Wouldn't take off for some reason there. Don't know why. Wouldn't take off. Probably didn't like me taking the Mickey. Well, I was actually complimenting it, really. I was going to say it probably didn't like me taking the Mickey out a bit. I was technically complimenting it on its gymnastic skills, really. So, when, why is this? Is this really important? Is that why they stick up in the air like that? Because I thought it was like over the other side of the planet, but you seem to be getting there quite quickly. Ish. What's this over here? Let's have a look. Let's have a look. Oh, yep. Landing spot. Can we land on the landing spot? There we go. So the little target marker came up, so that should mean I should be landing on the landing spot. In theory, we are going to get to the operation centre by the end of this episode. I think. Hopefully. Maybe in the next episode. Depends on what shiny things we see on the way. Shiny things. Okay. Let's go and have a look in here. Anything of interest in this direction? Right. It's one of those pop-up hangers. There we go. I don't know if they were only used for Harrier jump jets, but I know they were like the blow-up things. They because they could take off from anywhere. They had these blow-up hangers they could put up anywhere just to keep the crews dry while they fixed them. Stick it under a road bridge or something like that. Grenade propulsion towel. Travel at high velocity. Device leads to quicker land mass deformation results. Okay. Okay. If you say so. What have we got here then? Observatory. Outlook. Well, it does say observatory. Okay. The observatory has long been abandoned by its overseer. Thick layers of dust betray years of neglect, but the system remains online. There's no spider web, so maybe no space spiders. Thick layers of dust betray. Yeah, we've done that. But the system remains online, ever vigilant as they scan the sky. A beacon received from a distant alien world flashes on the monitor. You mean this planet? I bet you it's this planet, but it's not a distant alien world. All I need to discover its location is to enter the correct response. So it'd be 921. Yeah, we've seen this one before. I bet it's not on a different planet. See, it says a new location is revealed near to me. So we, oh, so we have discovered two. What would be the words? Writing books? I don't know. But we've seen that one many times. But we did discover the Hanel instead of channel, which we assumed instead of channel. Trying not to get dizzy looking around. Do 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 do. Oh, knowledge stone over there. Goldfish bro mode active. We're off to get the knowledge stone. Keep scanning, my boy, so we don't lose it. Oh, well. Oh, look at my jetpack skills. No. There we go. What do we got? Magnetic. Any more for any more? Any more? Any more? Oh, there's Now this is one of those yeah. Have we discovered this yet on this planet? Yes, we have. As a hint. He gets very excited when he hits you. He does like it, bless him. Or she does like it. I don't know. Oh, you'll be a humpback ant, will you? I don't know. Oh. Oh. You already discovered. What happened there? So is that where these white dots come from? Can I get rid of this white dot? Does that add like a sort of custom waypoint? Don't let's just go and have a look. Let's go and have a look. A looky look see. Let's open that. Just because nothing. Nothing. Nothing in there, Gav. Anybody? Hello? Oh, hello. Who are you then? It's just Nikki Credits. Thank you. Nikki Technology. We already know that one. So can we interact with this one? Yes. Oh, so I've just missed loads of credits just for what is that to do? I don't know, maybe they've just added it. I'm sure I've looked at loads of these before. It's the first thing I did when I was looking around one of these things and I saw this and I was like, this is like an iris scanner. And you probably heard this in the last episode, so I've fiddled now. Before we just sell loads of junk, if we have junk to sell, we'll see if he wants any of my junk. Alpha Maximum. Alfred Maximum. So, if I go, if I cross over, see there's that dot that she's floating. Well, has that got rid of it? Has that got rid of it? No. So how do I get rid of that? Does that just mean I have to log out? Would appreciate being helpful to put a waypoint, but so some friend Gek Trader friend language. The life form eyes, the life form's eyes widen in surprise when I go to talk to it. It leans back and watches for sudden movements. It's very clear. Right, it's very clear. He never seen anything quite like me before. As you can see, I'm not a very good storyteller. There we go. I mind that I can't speak its language and increasingly reassured the beaked trader. Well, yeah, okay, he is beaked, I'll give him that one. Indicates that in exchange for certain elements, it's willing to help. Well, carbon's really easy to get. Iron's really easy to get. And can't. But I haven't got any iridium, so let's just give him some oxygen. Oxide. Oh, I like that anyway. It teaches me some of the dialect of its people. There we go. Got common. Maybe it just taught me common as a insult because I need iron to get it rather than something more interesting. I don't know. There we go. We've got milestone accomplished. Learnt X number of words. Been insulted by an alien. Universal translator. Not quite. Well, I have been watching Starship Enterprise, Star Trek Enterprise, again recently on Netflix. And well, their universal translator's probably a little bit better than I am, but still has its bugs. A bit like my language skills. I'll do some. That's probably some iridium. Where were we going? We were going for this one. This one. Operation center. Right. Yes, I think this is. Right. Right. Getting a bit faster. Let's boot it a bit. Let's use the boosters. Go. It's not really much of a boost. Is it? Go faster. A little bit faster than that. Oh, picking up speed. I think there might be an issue with the turbo. We are going a bit faster than we were. Oh, there's a crash. Oh, a crash chip is over here as well. Shall we have a quick look at that as well as we are there? So boost. Can we go a bit higher and try and use boost? Let's try that then. So boost is 151 units speed. Just no, no. Okay, down to 151. Yeah, we're pushing it. We're pushing the envelope at 151 when we occasionally get there. It's not very fast then. Come on, you can. We need a whip for it or something, you know. It's going to take us a while, this, isn't it? It's going to take a while. This operation centre best be good. Okay, this is going to take a while, so I'm going to cut this bit out. We'll cut this bit out. So, I'll see you in a minute when we get there. We're nearly there yet? No, we're not. We will be in a minute, though. Okay, so we're nearly there now. I'm a little bit bored now, to be honest. Saved you the boredom, at least. I was pondering there whether it might have been easy just to kind of go out of the atmosphere and fly along and then come back in. But I don't know. Is this... All right, so this is the operation centre, is it? Is it one of those beacon things there? I did check because... are we going to be landing anywhere near it? No. I did check we weren't actually using Thamium or anything like that for that, which we aren't, because that's part of the boost system. Luckily, because it would have been a bit of a joke actually using fuel for that. just like you're kind of going downhill a little bit. in your old bucket with a rubbish engine. Yeah. Somebody crashed into the back of you is about the essence of that speed boost. So we'll find out what an operations centre is. Mithajmore. Okay. Where we going? Anything of interest to goldfish off to? Oh, okay. Round this way. Oh. Nice lamp. What else we got? Let's just get that. We never know what it is. We don't need to. Grenade in your face. And we're in. Right. Nothing that way. Well, there is stuff that way, but we don't have the Atlas Pass for it, so there's nothing that way. Are the credits in here? Yes, there are. Gutted now. Gutted. What have we got? Read encyclopedia. Ah, Gek word for bought it all. Right. Dibiniskiki workshop. Right. The security alert is scrambling the screen. It's a chaotic jumble of words. There's just enough visible text to point me towards the right workflow and potential to bring the installation back online. Something about docking. Planet trade platform, space station. It's geek. I'm just get planetary trade platform. Well, it just said docking. All right, it says docking. Docking is the only hit we got. A space station, you dock us. Yeah, the user's previous user's workflow is restored. Back online. Excellent. What do we got? Warp reactor Sigma. Hyperdrive is granted a more robust deep space exploration capabilities and ability to leap to stars previously out of reach. Please exercise caution when traveling alone in deep space. Why? Because your game may crash when you're loading? OK, Okay, so we've got warp reactor, Sigmar. Pulse engine, hyperdrive, warp reactor. Oh. Oh, well, we got that. Well, that was exciting, wasn't it? Pulse check Sigma provides stronger boost on space flights. Bit boring. So I can now dismantle that because I can then relearn. I wonder if I should have had a looked at that before. I wonder if you can learn how to build a photon cannon, for example. But because I can't actually rebuild it, it won't let me dismantle it. And I won't know that until, or if, I eventually discover the pattern to build a photon cannon. So I don't know. We'll have to. Maybe I might have a go and have a look at the other video and see if I can have this bit where I was looking around here and maybe decipher that a bit. See what happens. Here comes Dave. Dave's come slinking in. What's going on? Why are you slinking? Right. So we're miles away from... Anyway, let's go here. Let's go and have a look what this is. Should we go in this ship? Because it'll be a bit quicker. Yeah. Where's the ship? Is it right next to me again? No, it's over there. Let's try just jumping over this. There we go. What's the point in having a jetpack if you don't jump over things? Not much, really. So it was back that way, yeah, in case it doesn't show up. So we've got to do a 180, and we should find that point. Or just have a look around for... So Dave Cave, you know, he's obviously spotted something going on, because he came slinking in the room, and now he's just trotted off back outwards like something had happened. We'll find out. Right. Take off, thank you. 180. Maybe you should just go back over there. Because they're just going to bug me now. I'm just going to think they're the signal jammer thingy bob searchy things again. The thingy bob. Oh, there's one. Okay. Let's have a little landing. Oh. We could be in double bonus territory here. I think there's some lingo stones. And the signal thingy, Bob. Excellent. Bypass. Could be useful. Bypass stone. Bypass chip. Oh. Conveniently landed next to each other. Should we have a look? Let's have a quick look. Exosuit. Exosuit. Let us craft a couple of these. We'll see if we can get some lingo and some more manufacturing plants close by, rather than spending another 5 minutes going back to the other ones. Although we're now going to spend 5 minutes, well, not that long, watching me do this. Oh yeah, there you go. Can't have everything. Yep, look, periscope, alien artifacts. Oh, that's another plaque. Turn me round. There we go. Colonial outpost. Oh, make sure I get the right one. So I still hold down the button for a long time, even though I don't need to. So I might as well just take that thing off. Manufacturing facility detected. Okay. Monolith. Actually, was there a thing to sell stuff in there? Can't remember now. No, that was in the last place we went to. So there's a plaque over there anyway. I was going to show you what I meant with the thing that you couldn't precisely get rid of the amount of things that you wanted. Manufacturing facility. Okay, let's go searchy-worchy then. Because I'm now just gibbering on. Where's my ship? There we are. Hey, there we are. There's my ship. Right, Bendu. gonna call this ship. Unless you could name your ships, so that's the one thing that's really missing, isn't it? I'd call this ship Bender after, because it does look like Bender's face, I think. Oh, we got another thing here. It's land down here, and the plaque's quite maybe. Well, we have landed, but I don't think we're anywhere near it though. What's this? Is this anything? Ah, cargo drop. That's convenient. Viking dagger. Are we miles away now, aren't we? Is that? No, that's not a... That's the one there. I heard a noise then. I wasn't sure if it was the game or next door tapping something. I think that's definitely next door. Let me take my headphone off a bit. Don't know. I stopped it now. Yeah. If you hear any tapping, that's next door. Just get a double bed. Your mum and dad know. Your mum and dad ain't stupid. They know all about it. They probably did that themselves. Analyze multi-tool, recoil stabilizer. I already known yet. Okay, already got that one. I should look out for that a bit more, really, just to make it obvious that, rather than looking at, oh, is it something shiny new? No, it's not. I don't know what I'm missing on the multi-tool patterns, but it could be like one of these card trading games where something's really, really rare and you have to keep searching. You have to buy like millions of packs to get the one in the world. Already known. We went in that one, didn't we? We went in that one. Any loot? Yeah, any loot. No, okay. Well, we don't want to do that because we've just done that. We've just done bypass shipping. So back to the ship then. God, it's winking at me. Oh, I think... Titanium. Ooh. Nice. I don't find much titanium around. I think the only time I tend to find titanium, apart from buying it, of course, is you seem to get either titanium or nickel by killing the sentry bot. So, are we going for frame rate stutter bug? Have we? Yeah, we're going for a frame rate stutter bug. Okay. So I'll be passing this one on to Sean Murray as well. There we go. Frame rate stutter bug. This is what it looks like. Super slow-mo. Frame rate stutter bug. Yeah. Please do not reach your tellies. It is just there. It's me. Well, it's the game. Okay. Well, I collected something there, so we'll get in the ship. And... we'll get back out of the ship to make sure it's saved, so I don't have to collect those again in the future. Yes, okay. Is that... I don't know. No, still not. Still, well, no, still not good. Okay, well, I'll have to reload the game to do this anyway, so this seems like a good opportunity to end this episode. Thank you very much for watching. Remember, if you did like this episode, please do a like, subscribe, comment, and share. If you didn't like this episode, please leave a comment as well, tell me why. and hopefully I'll be passing this on to Sean Murray to show him this bug, along with the previous one where I got kicked out of the ship and stuck underground. So there you go. So yes, thank you very much for watching. Like, subscribe, comment and share, and bye bye for now. See you again in the next episode.